In this video, I'm going to show you how to convert your old Dyson to run on 18 volt power tool batteries such as Milwaukee, DeWalt, Makita or Bosch batteries. So stick around and I'll show you how to convert yours. For this conversion, you're going to need a old Dyson cordless vacuum, a 24 volt relay, a small block of wood, two screws, some wire, your original Dyson battery. If you want to see how to remove this from your Dyson, check out the video just here in the card. Then you'll need a battery adapter, one of these for a Milwaukee m18, one of these for a Bosch battery, one of these for a DeWalt XR battery, and I got one of these for a Makita LXT. Links to all these parts are in the description below. If you have any questions, don't forget to leave them in the comments. To open up these batteries, there's a small Torx screw just in the back of here. Once you remove that, unclip the side here, and there's a clip here, one on each side, and then two at the bottom here, and again one on each side here, here and here. Once you've removed those, you can then remove the front half of the battery. It will then slide off. Be careful because there's a spring just in here and that will go flying. So remove the spring and the grey piece. Put them to the side. You're going to need those again in a minute. Then remove the front half of the battery. Remove the wires from that. We don't need the charging port anymore. Then you can remove the actual battery pack. Right. On this board, we're going to need this switch here, and we're going to reuse this circuit board. So remove those carefully, like this. So with this and this, we're going to use this small switch here to switch this relay, which will then supply power to this from here. A very quick explanation of the wiring diagram. So here we have the 18 volt battery. Here's the battery adapter of your choice. The black wire, the negative wire, goes straight up to the negative terminal. This is the correct way to do this. Do not try and do it through a little click switch, because these are just not designed to cope with the amperage that these lithium batteries can put out. Fire up your soldering iron. We're going to make up the wiring for this. So you're going to need to adapt this to go on there. Use this piece of wood for in a minute. That's going to hold that onto there. Drill a small hole and then feed your wiring. This is great if you've got a Milwaukee battery, a DeWalt battery. This could be done with any of the big tall manufacturers' batteries. The only thing you need to change for any of this conversion is this battery adapter. This is very easy to do. A plus, so I know when I'm working on this which side is plus and minus. So these are our power switched and this is our coil switched. So we need to go from red to red, plus to plus, and then from there to plus on the base of this circuit board. And we're also going to need to use the switch on one side of this, so we might as well go blue to blue on this, and then put power across these two here. So that will need to go across these two in either way round, it doesn't matter. So I'm going to solder this to here. It's not massively pretty, but it will do quite nicely. With all the solder joints now finished, so we've got the switch, switching the coil in the relay, got ground to the switch side of the coil, and you've got live coming to the live side, and that's the switch and that's the coil, and the coil is triggered by the switch here. So that's the soldering part all completed. Now we can slide the board back in. We've now got the circuit board held in, the relay held in. I had to extend the wiring coming up to the switch because I've just done it a little bit too short. But now everything's in place. The switch is back in place just with that extended wiring. The circuit board now holds itself in place. So we can reinstall the spring. We can reinstall the grey switch catch. And then that's that part done. I'm thinking I might just put something in front of this just to make sure this holds itself in place. So I'm just going to use a little bit of black mastic. And we can reinstall the front cover, making sure that my wiring is going to get caught. There we are. It's the front cover back on. Need to reinstall that small screw. There we are. It's now all clipped back together very nicely. That's the Makita Milwaukee DEWALT battery conversion complete. Now we just need to reinstall this into our Dyson. We shall reinstall the two screws, just like that. We need to reinstall our dustbin and get a battery. If you'd like to watch more Makita content, repair and restoration videos, click on this playlist here. And if you'd like to watch more videos on the Dyson, click on this playlist here. Thanks for watching.